He had a natural gift and natural ability and for sound and an intellect that allowed him to pursue it to the very ends of what is possible by human beings. His voice is as good as anything happening that was happening in the world, not very well known outside Canada, just because of the way the world works.
Like all Canadian composers in the 40s and 50s, he was largely ignored.
Composer Norma Beecroft.
Perhaps broadcasting helped him develop his image and television, and maybe in particular television, because Harry was something beautiful to look at as well as to listen to. Not all of his music was all that accessible, but it all represented parts of him.
Summer's widow, actress Barbara Chilcott, thinks his music doesn't just represent part of him, it is him. You can't know who he is without knowing the music, and even then he remains elusive.
He never revealed more of himself than he was willing to let that particular person see at that particular point in time. This Scots background on his mother's side of the family, her name was Mackay. She was, you know, fairly buttoned up, as J.B. Priestley would say. And I think that it was through his music that he allowed himself to be unguarded. But what he was guarding, I have not quite figured out.
He lived in a house where mother and father slept at different ends of the house. A mother who was a little bit kooky and off-center and artistic, and a father who was a president of an insurance company. They never divorced, which is, you know, I don't know whether that would have been better or not. I have no idea. But he grew up in that atmosphere of hatred. We had two people who had no use for each other. They had two sons. Bob, who was more like the father, but a soft-spoken guy. Nice guy, actually, Bob. And Harry, who was obviously the apple of his mother's eye, very much so. And it must have stirred up a lot of hostility in him.
Harry Summers' old friend Irene Bird thinks that Summers responded to all of this by becoming withdrawn and guarded.
Basically, he was shy. His whole life was his music and his composing. That was everything for Harry. Harry was just special. I mean, he was put into this world in a special planet of his own.
In a conversation with Norma Beecroft in the early 70s, Harry Summers remembered that planet as an enchanted place.